If I may ask.
Sure, I'm from India.
From India?
Yeah.
You're here for work or leisure?
No, I live here.
You live here?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you work in one of the PPOs, maybe?
No. I work in a different sector altogether. Uh-huh. My wife is Bulgarian.
Ah.
So that brings me to
okay,
Bulgaria.
So you're married with a Bulgarian. Yeah. Where did you meet?
We met in the UK. We studied together.
Okay.
Are you from Bulgaria?
Yes, but I lived in Denmark most of my life.
Ah, okay.
So I recently came back here a couple of years ago.
Yeah, it's... I had a big goof up because I came to know about this event on Facebook.
Yes, me too.
And if you remember on the picture, they were having the dance
yeah.
picture.
Uh-huh.
I did not read the description.
You thought it was some kind of...
Some kind of cultural event. I was just talking to my wife right now. Well, I thought it was some kind of cultural event, so I should have read the description with Google Translate, of course.
Yeah.
I should have taken my wife's help to know, but I didn't exactly know it was a protest.
It should have been much bigger. They said there would be around 10,000 people with yellow vests, and like in France, if you have seen the demonstrations.
I don't know about the political scene in this country, and... Now that I've come over here, now that I've spoke to a lady in the crowd, when I came here, I didn't see the dance and I saw the protest, and I'm like, am I the right place? So I asked someone, like, what's going on over here? And she explained me the whole water situation in Pernik, and I didn't know about it, but now I really hope this gets sorted soon. I mean, it's not a joke that, that the whole city doesn't have water. It's terrible. It's terrible. I'm from the environmental sector, so... I knew this was coming. I just didn't know in which all places in the world this would come. But
so climate change is not a hoax?
Oh, it's not a hoax at all.
Yeah.
It's not. How can it be a hoax where we have an overwhelming evidence, a science-based evidence?
Yeah.
You know, stating the facts and stating that it's there. It's real.
Yeah.
You cannot be ignorant on such an overwhelming evidence in front of you. However, you can't always just link everything to climate change as well. I think this might be influenced by it, but I think this looks more like a local issue.
Yes.
Maybe the water is not sustainably managed, or
actually,
I don't know what's going on. I have no clue.
Actually, the mayor, he is now arrested in the city because he gave the water. There was a limited amount of water, and he gave some company the right to use all the water. And
he was
warned that this would happen, and he ignored it, and he gave them the right to use the water.
Yeah.
And so now he's arrested, actually.
I don't know. I won't say anything on that. But as I thought that it might be a water management issue, and I think what you're saying is pretty much they didn't properly manage the water properly.
Yeah.
But I really hope they get what they want. You can't live without water.
No,
you can't. I mean, it's
in India. There's also probably this kind of problem somewhere.
Yes, there are many places where.
They don't
where
even
a
have
drought,
one.
And there are many places where there is flooding. So I mean, India is a very big country.
Yeah.
And the terrain, the geographical spread of India, it can't be compared to Bulgaria.
No, of course.
So India has different water issues in different kind of parts. Sometimes it's about the water quality. Sometimes it's about the water availability. Sometimes it's about mismanagement. Sometimes it's a lot of things going on. We have our own issues as well. However, this is very, I don't know, I came for the cultural thing, but I didn't know there was a protest. But nonetheless, I really hope that these guys get what they want. It's unimaginable to live without water.
And, also, in a European country, it shouldn't be like this in a European country. It shouldn't be like this anywhere.
It shouldn't be like this anywhere in the world, I think.
Of course.
And it's not about a European country or developed nation. I think the more indigenous tribes in other parts of the world who have not been developed as far as our standards have been sustainably managing water and other resources for thousands of years.
Yes.
And we should be learning from them.
Yes.
I'm sure there are a lot
I
of
agree.
Tribes in Africa, in India, in Amazon, and you know, all those underdeveloped or undeveloped...
Uncivilized.
Uncivilized. But but we can learn a lot of principles from them.
Yes.
They are the ones who should be teaching us sustainability principles. It's not the fancy people in UN or whoever, I mean, with all due respect, what they say is relevant, but there are voices that are unheard as well. We should be a very important stakeholder in all the discussions.
Yes.
So, I don't know, I don't subscribe to that whole European cities should have water, other people may
shouldn't
or may not.
Have. No.
Yeah, that's, everyone should have water. Everyone should have water, clean air, and access to sustainable food. I mean,
but
that's basic.
But we are becoming more and more humans. Sooner or later, we will become more humans than there is water if we keep on like this.
I hope I'm really wrong, but the next wars in the world are going to be based on water.
Water.
Now it's oil. Everyone knows it's about
what
oil.
What about data?
Data and everything is also, but it doesn't impact everyone in this world.
Mm.
What I saw right now in this crowd is a lot of people who are above 60 and 70. I saw a lot of babas and I saw a lot of diados who are protesting. I mean, one of the persons out there is having a stick and he's protesting.
Yeah.
He's seen enough shit already in his life.
Yeah.
He shouldn't be out here protesting for water. He's not concerned about the data.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So the data impacts, like say, an X percentage of the global population. Water impacts everyone.
Mm.
Water impacts 100% of the people over here. So the data problem might come later.
Yeah.
So water problem comes first.
Mm.
You know? And it impacts everyone.
Yes.
You can live without data. You can live without internet.
Yeah.
You can't live without water.
Yeah, you're right.
So I think this is a very, hence we say it's a basic need.
Mm.
You know, it's a need. It's not a want or a desire.
Yeah.
It's a need which has to be satisfied.
Mm.
It's really, I don't know, it's really unfortunate. I mean, I really hope this protest comes out and, I mean, it results into something and they get what they want.
Yeah, I saw they were delivering water by truck over there, and before the truck stopped, some quick people had already taken all the water, so the old people could not get any water.
So that is sad.
You know, that when society breaks down, then it becomes a chaos. And
see, that is really sad, and I don't know, I mean, it's just goes to show how important water is.
Yeah.
Because when you are not having it, now you all of a sudden have it.
Yeah.
You don't look at you're not that considerate about the old people. You just want to have the first bucket for yourself.
Yes.
Because you're desperate, and desperate people do desperate things.
Yeah.
In a way, I don't blame that because this is classical human behavior. However, I do condemn it because you're, as a society, we are failing. So we should be, in theory, be considerate enough for everyone, but because humans are, most of us are not wired this way to think about others.
Yeah.
We would just get all the water from the pipe as much as we can and fill our houses first and then think about others. And that's how we have, unfortunately, that's how we are wired.
Yeah.
You know, it's how the culture is, unfortunately. So I don't blame that, I don't support that, and I don't blame that.
No.
If I see my family dying with thirst, I would probably do the same. I would be forced to do the same.
Yeah.
These people are forced to do it.
Yeah.
Don't blame the people. Blame the
government.
I don't know the government or whoever.
I can feel you don't want to say it. Maybe you are concerned that you are new here. Maybe and you.
No, I don't. I was just talking to my wife right now, saying how big a goof up this was because I thought it was a cultural event and now it's a protest and I don't want to take part in this protest. Because my words to my wife is that I'm not a citizen of this country.
Yeah.
I have no right to say in any matters relating to the state.
But you know, when there is a protest in India, the West, they also say, come and say, we don't like this, we don't like that.
Well,
you know, people come in and from all over the world participate in it, so you should have the right.
No,
also.
I should not. I don't stop the West from commenting. But I don't support them as well because it's not your matter.
Yeah.
You should first clean your house and then look into other people's houses. And I would not like to comment anything political because I'm not a citizen of this country. I'm just here since August and I don't know the political landscape or the social landscape of this country. I, with my best intentions, thought it was a cultural dance event and I really came to see that. But it's a political event. I respect. I just hope on humanitarian grounds that people, what they're protesting, they get it. But I have no stance on it.
Mm.
I don't want to make a stance on it because I don't want to interfere in your country's political affairs. It's not right on my part.
Yeah.
It is not right on my part. I'm not a citizen. I know my limitations. I don't want to comment anything which is beyond my limits.
Yeah.
I'm sure the people over here are capable enough to get what they want, and as a human being, I would wish that they get water at least, and that's that's essential. That's
it's strange that you have this opinion that you don't want. I usually, that's one of the differences between people in the, for example, in the East and, yeah. and in the West,
yeah.
that they feel in the West, they feel entitled to, you know, to tell all everybody what is human rights, for example,
of course,
or
yeah, yeah.
what is this, or how should you manage the water, for example,
yeah,
or,
yeah.
or things like.
I don't support that. As I said, I don't support that, but I don't condemn that as well.
Wow.
If they want to comment on my country's affairs, let them. I don't want to stop it.
No.
I don't want to be. Let them do whatever they want to. You know
yeah.
that they are not the voters of my system. They are not going to influence. Hopefully not in any way. The affairs of my country. But if they want to say some opinions, they are most welcome. Sometimes it can be good.
Yeah.
But the reason why I don't want to say anything.
But this is also good because this is water for the people. So.
Yeah. But I on humanitarian grounds, I wish what they want, they get it soon. But.
You don't want to put blame.
No, I can't. I don't want. No, I can't. Firstly, I can't. Secondly, I don't want to because I don't want to interfere in the sovereignty of the Republic of Bulgaria. This is. You know, I take these things very, very seriously.
Yes.
I don't know this country enough. How can I comment politically or how can I comment socially?
Mm.
Yeah, if there is someone who is thirsty in front of me, if I can help. So many times when I walk in the center, when I see homeless people, I don't give them money, but I just buy a loaf of bread and I give them.
Mm.
But I don't politically comment that this country has a lot of homeless people.
Yes.
I don't need to. If I see a problem, I solve it. And I do the most I can. The best I can is that just wish and pray for these people to get water as soon as possible. But I don't want to be a part of the protest because I respect the sovereignty of your country.
Mm.
I don't want to see, you know, where foreigners just come and do, I don't know, protest and then they go away. They don't. We guys don't care, honestly, in a way.
Yeah.
You just see. You just see a mass meeting and you just take part in it and you have some fun and go away. That's not really contributing.
No.
If I can contribute with my knowledge somehow to solve the problem, I would love to.
Mm.
But I would not want to be involved in any such protests.
No.
But I would like to wish all the best to the people in terms of getting what they want.
Yeah.
Whether the protest is successful or unsuccessful, that's not my prerogative. That's not something for me to answer. But I hope they get the water. Because it's a very serious issue. It's a very serious issue. I just hope everyone is better off.
Where are you from in India?
Mumbai. So we have a lot of water.
Yeah.
But I've always had 24 hours of access to water and I've personally never faced water issues, but I have been working in the social sector.
There are some parts there where people still have to carry the water.
Yes, I have. That's what I'm saying. So I've been working in the social sector for a long time and I've been to places where small children have to walk 3 to 5 miles every day to just get one pot of water on their heads and it's terrible. It's terrible. I've done some work on that.
Yeah.
I've been very vocal on that in my own country.
Mm.
Because it's my right to voice an opinion. No one can stop me from doing that. But all I can do is just wish them all the best and hope that they get what they want. And
I think you're very interesting. Tell me more about yourself.
I don't know. What do you want to know?
Like, what do you do here, for example, if it's not a secret?
No, it's not a secret at all. I used to run a social venture back home. A lot of people in India don't have access to electricity. About when I started my work, 300 million people did not have access to electricity.
Uh-huh.
And when I saw that problem, I decided to do something about it. So I started with a venture called Pico Energy.
What?
Pico, it's like Pico Energy, but it's combined into Pico Energy. I designed a solar home lighting system for the financially poor people who didn't have access to electricity. So it was a very affordable solar home lighting and a mobile charging device system which we used to install in people's houses who were relying on candles and kerosene etc. for lighting. And even at that time I was not protesting or I was not having a huge political stance against the state or the government. I think we should also understand their perspective as well. You know, the government is also doing the best that they can, but there is also a civil society which has to do a lot to make a good society. So I started this social venture with a clear aim that if I see a problem, if I see someone living in dark, I will go and by some means I will install my solar lights over there so that the person gets electricity.
That's very good.
Yeah, I mean that's how I solve things.
Mm.
And then of course we had some interest from the local government.
You believe in solving things locally, like
I actually believe in solving things quick. I mean, there is enough technology out there. There is enough brain power out there. There is enough resources out there. It's just about you need someone or a group of people coming together and mobilizing all these energies and resources and solving a problem.
Mm.
Protests and everything are also a very important part of awareness creation, but I'm not really sure how long it would take for them to actually result into something quantifiable or something impactful on the ground.
Yes.
Whereas the other alternative is just have a collective, have a group of people, have some, I don't know, town hall meetings and see how we can remedy the situation as soon as possible as well. Both the approaches are very important.
Mm.
They should go parallel at the same time. Yeah, that's what I believe.
I grew up in Denmark, and in Denmark it's a lot different than here, for example. There it's much more...
I don't know, I've never been there, so... But, yeah...
But now you will get a Bulgarian citizenship hopefully soon.
No, I don't know. I'm not really aware. That's not my priority.
And when you can travel all around. You can live everywhere in Europe. If you and your girlfriend want to try something different, you could always.
Maybe I don't know. It's not on the.
Do you watch a lot of YouTube?
No, sometimes yeah.
Do you know Loi Masiru?
No, I don't.
No, he's an Indian personal branding coach. I watch a lot of his things.
Okay.
He's very interesting.
Okay.
He talks about Dubai mostly because he has lived in Dubai.
Okay, okay. Yeah.
But he has very interesting opinions and you know talks a lot about.
Cool.
I've worked in a couple of Indian companies here actually.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow, that's interesting.
One called Sutherland Global Services.
I know it's BPO, isn't it?
Yes, yeah, BPO.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Heard about it. Yeah.
It's okay, pretty good. We had the Indian bosses and everything. So
okay, I think I know. What's the guy's name? Satish?
You know Satish? But how do you know him?
I just met him at a social event. At some...
For Indians, maybe?
Yeah. But tomorrow is Indian Republic Day at the embassy. You're most welcome. You can come.
Can you invite me? I want to film for my
welcome.
YouTube channel.
Everyone's welcome. There's no invitation needed. You just turn up at the embassy, Indian embassy at 9:30, I guess, and
in the morning,
yeah.
9:30.
The event starts at 9:45 or 9:30ish or something like that. I don't know. You might bump into Satish over there as well. I'm guessing a lot of Indian people would turn up.
I think maybe he hates me because I got fired from there, but but it would be fun.
Yeah.
And can you think I can film over there?
I don't know. I have no idea.
I will try to go there then,
yeah.
Film for my YouTube channel and.
You have a YouTube channel.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Was this conversation being recorded? I don't know.
It's live actually.
Oh, it's live.
Actually, we have. Should have some people maybe have commented something.
Oh shit! I just hope. Are you gonna put it on the archive or something?
It's a small channel. Somebody has commented on talking about Australia is the same like here with the fires. So people have commented.
Oh, I just hope I didn't say anything which might.
It's not even aimed at Bulgaria. It's mainly at international and at Denmark. There's no Bulgarians watching it. It's
okay.
Still
okay.
Also very small.
What's your channel? Maybe I like to.
Crazy Bulgarian. It's good when you subscribe. Maybe YouTube will push it to India more. The algorithm, when somebody from India, you know, then YouTube will say, hey, maybe it's relevant for other Indians, and then they will.
This is you?
Yes.
Is you?
You can. You should. If you click on the video, you should be able to see yourself.
Really?
Or see what I'm seeing.
That's interesting.
So it's a little.
I shit.
But it's still very small, don't worry, nobody's gonna see it.
Oh my god, but...
You didn't say anything compromising in any way, so you are very diplomatic. I think you could have said even, you could easily have said a lot more and...
No, I don't want to, I really don't want to. Yeah. I really don't want to, because it's, as I said, I wasn't aware that it was being live, but I mean it. I should not be commenting in other countries' affairs. It's not the right thing to do. I have enough problems back home, which I can comment on, and I should not be poking my nose in something that I don't understand completely.
Yeah.
It's not right. It's not right. Mm. We should all try to clean our homes first.
Yeah.
Then going out and saying anything to others. I don't think that's the right thing to do. He seems fancy to take his interview.
Wow, suddenly there's a lot more here. 13 people watching. I'm trying to grow my YouTube channel, so I've been watching a lot of IRL streams, people that just stream their life, and that's very interesting to me. So I'm trying to get into it, and sometimes it's a little hard, so I try to find some events and stream something from different events.
Well, I wish you all the best for the channel.
Yes.
Malik Ali.
I'll see you tomorrow at the Indian Embassy if you are there.
I will be there for sure. But I'm not sure about the filming part, so you can...
I will try. If not, then I will just go.
Yeah. Again. Satish should be there as well. Anyways, see ya. Bye. Take care.
Thank you very much. See ya. So that was a pretty interesting guy from India who was watching the demonstration. But it is pretty dead now, so there's not gonna be any major things here, I think. You don't think he will be there? I think... Maybe if he has nothing to do. But he told me my old boss will be there, and I got fired from that work, and they hated me pretty much, so... It could be interesting. The Indian Embassy, they would probably tell me not to film. I don't know, maybe if I can film, it would be interesting to see Indian get together in Bulgaria. Even the fire department, they expected around 10,000 people here, so there were actually more police than there were demonstrators. I didn't film them all, but basically they were around, so you couldn't see them all, but there were a lot of police. Yeah, Indians are very like that, they are very afraid of the image and stuff like that, so maybe that even scared him off. I wanted to invite him over for a drink or something and talk more about him, because I think maybe it's interesting for the viewers. Yeah, Indians, they dance a lot in these events.